Hey guys, so first let's start off with your first and last name. You first, please.
Omar Sabha.
And you, sir?
Abed Sabha.
Cool. Thank you guys for being here at CW39. This is our digital dive, and you guys were just on TV talking about this documentary and your experience coming to the U.S. Tell us a little bit about the documentary and what we can expect if we go.
Sure. So the documentary is about lives of refugees outside of Syria, their journey towards finding a safe place for themselves and families. It's an emotional piece, really well put out. It does tell a lot about the different types of struggles that people might face, families in specific, and the emotional stress and the decisions that they need to make in order to find a safe place for their children.
Yeah, that's good. Well,
yeah.
And there is some. You guys play a part in that. Your brother told us here at CW39 he was part of the violence and was hit by a bomb, right? Correct?
Yes.
And you had to come over here for medical attention?
Yes, I did.
Okay, tell us about that.
So when I was just about 10 years old, I was hit by a bomb in Syria. And my brother put a lot of effort into taking me to another country to get me the right medical treatment, and that's why we ended up in America eventually. And and at first it was in Pennsylvania, New York, America, and then about 2 years ago we moved to Houston, and that's how I ended up here.
Well, welcome to Houston, and you guys live in the Katy area. We're proud that you guys are here, and we're excited to see this film. You said it's emotional. You guys were also called to be part of it. How did that feel for this director to say, hey, we want you guys to be part of this film? How did that feel?
It was not an easy decision to put your story out there, to get filmed in a close-up shots every other day. Your daily life, your daily struggles. Kind of put everything out there for the people to know about it, but I think it was the right decision. Now that it's come out, I mean, we understand that it does bring a lot of awareness. It does talk about a lot of the struggles that refugees in the United States and other countries do face. And I think it was a great experience overall, and we're glad that we did it.
And your life experience, obviously, it brought you guys closer together.
Yes.
Tell me about how that, from 10 years old, having to travel, what's going through, what were your thoughts or what were you thinking as you saw your brother helping you and you guys going to Pennsylvania, New York, and then finally to Houston?
Right. So, I mean, as a child, I didn't really comprehend what was going on as much as I would have now. So back then, my mentality was I was just excited to go to another country. Now that I'm grown and I realize, I can comprehend what happened a little more, I'm very thankful to have my brother for helping me to get this opportunity, because I don't think I would have ever had that.
And we talked about anybody that goes to the screening, the proceeds go to helping refugees, right? And helping the situation back in your home country, correct?
Yes, that's true. Although, it's been a while since, the awful incident happened in Turkey and Syria. But they're still trying to treat the situation. There's still a lot of affected families that haven't gotten the help they need, and still a lot of rescue taking place over there. So, this is a good thing. Everybody who's going to show up to this screening, I think they're, automatically participating and helping those folks out. I think that's a very noble and great thing to do.
Absolutely. We think the same thing. That's why we wanted to have you guys here. We hope everybody in Houston gets a chance to go. But if they don't, we're going to put information on this web story that we're going to produce that's going to have the resources that people just plain and simple, where they can help out if they didn't go to the screening. So we thank you guys. Anything else that you want to add or you want to say before we finish?
I I don't know.
And it's okay if you don't. Thank you guys.
You got to point something out, or I could say something, but I mean, it's 7 in the morning for me still.
Oh, yeah, it's really, yeah, that's right. It's really for us, too. So you guys have seen the film, right?
Of course, a number of times.
And tell me, just tell me what you think about it. Like, when you're seeing yourself on camera, how does that feel? And then we'll finish with that.
Okay. Yeah, so it's a lot of, I mean, the film did come out a couple of years after, and it brings a lot of memories, especially that at the time that it was being filmed, I was driving a truck for a living, delivering appliances, and I really got a gracious opportunity to be interviewed for, you know, a position in a software company, and things were different. So, you know, to watch yourself, what you did in the past, and I think it brings a lot of pride, honestly, because we're always thriving, we're always trying to move forward, and what we did in the past keeps, you know, inspiring us to keep going forward.
That's awesome.
Yes.
What about yourself?
Yeah, like he said, it's very nostalgic to look into to see ourselves on film. It's it brings back a lot of memories, and it shows you where you were in the past and how much you've grown since then and learned since then. Yeah, it's kind of surreal to see yourself on cameras also. So.
Well, we can't wait to see this film, documentary film. And we're also going to put your social media handles up on our web script, so if people want to contact you directly, they can, all that kind
of
stuff.
Of course.
Thank you guys again. It was a pleasure to meet you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so
much.
Appreciate
it.